Let's go back to the draft period for you. When you were third on the clock, did you get any calls for the trade the pick for somebody who wanted Jordan? Did you get any calls for that?
You know, Rich, not when we were on the clock. We didn't. We had had a bunch of calls prior to the draft from teams who were interested in the third pick. I can assume that they were interested in Jordan with that pick, but there were several teams who were interested. There were a couple teams that were more interested than others, made, you know, what I think, you know, people would probably call reasonable offers for that particular pick.
Do you remember the names of the teams? Do you remember any of the names of the teams, Rod, that you thought,
The two teams who made the better offers were Philadelphia and Dallas.
Okay. What could have been? And you just said, no, thank you. What could have been? And you said,
well,
no, thank you.
We knew about a week before the draft that Jordan would be available. Portland, in my conversations with Stu Inman, who was the GM of the Blazers, had told me that if Sam Bowie passed his physical, they would draft him. And about a week before the draft, I called him and asked him if Bowie passed, and he said yes. And I asked him if they were still going to draft him, and he said yes. So we knew a week before the draft that unless you know, some crazy trade or something happened, which sometimes does around drafts, that Jordan would be available at number 3.
So was this a time where people didn't lie about their intentions for a draft, Ron? I mean, you took Stu's word for it there?
No.
Okay.
No.
Right.
But, I knew Stu, you know, very well, and he was not the kind of lie or the kind of guy who was, if he told you, you know, he might tell you it's none of your business or we haven't made up our mind yet, but in this case he didn't, and he was telling the truth.
So prior to you receiving this information, or potentially in the event that he might have had his lips moving and it wasn't really true, what was your backup plan at number 3 if Jordan was gone? What would you have done?
If Jordan had been gone, we would have taken Sam Perkins. My feeling, you know, Charles Barkley was in that draft.
Mm-hmm.
And my feeling about Barkley, and I scouted Barkley a bunch of times, was that he was too small to do in the NBA what he was doing at Auburn. And you know, Sam Perkins had a nice career and was a very good player, but that would have been a mistake.
Well, I'm assuming that you spoke to Dean Smith about both Tar Heels. What was your conversation with Dean Smith about Jordan prior to that draft, Rod?
Well, you know, I had developed a relationship with Coach Smith. You know, we'd go down and watch practice from time to time, and at the end of every year, he would allow me to come in and watch his tapes where, you know, you could scout not only the Tar Heels but also the other ACC teams. And in Michael's junior year when he came out, you know, I'm watching tape and, you know, he stands out, you know, like a sore thumb with his athleticism, with how much better he had gotten from the time he entered North Carolina until his junior year. And when I was talking to Coach Smith after watching tape all day, he said to me that, and he would never say it publicly because, you know, that's not the Carolina way, that Jordan was the most talented player that he had coached. And he said he's a really solid, good person on top of it. But, you know, he would never say that publicly.
But he said that to you, and how did that land with you when you heard him say something like that?
Well, I was a big advocate of Coach Smith. I thought he was a great coach.
Sure.
And I thought he prepared his players very well for the NBA. If you look at Carolina players over the course of time, and particularly when Coach Smith was there, most of his players were better pros than they were college players. There aren't many coaches you can say that about. Some coaches get everything it's possible to get out of a player when he's in college, and then when you get him in pro ball, they don't improve that much. Most Carolina players under Coach Smith, and I think part of it was the way they played. You know, they didn't put any one player above any other player. They played a very team-oriented game, and they really delved into the fundamentals of the game, and most of their players became better pros.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.